When you develop a user interface, you want it to look good on any screen, regardless of its resolution. Autoplay Menu Designer gives you this opportunity. Your application is not limited to just one size and can be adapted to the current screen resolution automatically. In this lesson, we will look at basic principles of developing a scalable application. I created a demo project in advance to study. As you can see, this page is divided into several blocks for clarity. In a work project, there could be buttons, captions, images, and other interface elements instead of blocks. So let's open Window Object Settings and go to the Window Size Properties dialog. First of all, turn on the Allow Resizing checkbox to allow resizing of the window in runtime mode. It allows to test how our interface changes when the window is resized. I recommended to turn off this option before publishing of the project, but in the edit mode, it will help us a lot. Next, set the window size. The window size determines the size of our entire application. You can select the full screen mode or specify the window size as a percent of the screen. Thus, the application will look the same on both the big and the small screen. For the test, it will set 60% of the screen width and 60% for the screen height. Let's see the result. As you can see, the page inside the window does not change its size. Now open the page settings. Go to Size and Position dialog and turn on both Stretch to the Window checkboxes. As you can see, now the page and all its objects are scaled together with the window. If you want to preserve the aspect ratio of the page, use only one checkbox in the Maintain Aspect Ratio option. If the page size becomes larger than the window size, scrolling will be available automatically. This is how the default scaling works. However, if necessary, you can specify individual scaling parameters for each object. Let's study how it works. Each visual object on the page has its own scaling options. These options are available if the page scaling is enabled. It's important to understand that parameters determine how the object will behave when the parent object is resized, where the parent object is the parent page or the parent group if the object is grouped. The following options are available separately on horizontal and vertical. Left, top alignment. The object does not change its size and keeps the distance to the left top edge of the parent object. Center alignment. The object does not change its size and is always located in the center of the parent object, even if it's not located in the center in the edit mode. Right, bottom alignment. The object does not change its size and keeps the distance to the right bottom edge of the parent object. Stretch. The object changes its size by the amount of change in the size of the parent object. For example, if the parent object is changed on 10 pixels, then the child object will be changed on 10 pixels. The distance to the left top edge of the parent object does not change. Proportional stretch is the default option. The object changes size in proportion to the size of the parent object. For example, if the child object occupied 50% of the parent object, then at any change of the parent object, it will still be 50%. The distance to the left top edge of the parent object also changes proportionally. No action. The object keeps its absolute position and size. The option is recommended only if you specify the position and size of the object using internal variables. Let's look at it in practice. Suppose we want to stretch vertically along the Block 5 object and leave the rest as is. We should specify the bottom alignment option for each of Block 6, 7, 8 objects. For each of block 1, 2, 3, 4 objects, we should specify the top alignment option. Obviously, if there are many objects, it will take a lot of time, but we just can group the top objects into one group and specify the top alignment option for it. Now, lower and upper objects are fixed, and it remains to specify the stretch option for the block 5 object. Test our project. The task is completed. Now let's fix the size of the block 8 by horizontal. To change correctly the size of the block 6 and 7, we can set the left alignment option for the block 6 and set the stretch option for the block 7. Test our project. The task is completed. But what if we want to change the size of the block 6 and 7 proportionally? Let's return the proportional stretch mode for blocks 6 and 7. Group them. And specify the stretch option for new group. Let's see the result. Now the blocks 6 and 7 stretch proportionally. Note that you can include one group in another if you need more complex behavior. Suppose we wanted to scale the top group by vertical together with the block 5. If we specify the proportional stretch or stretch mode for it, we will not get the desired result. But if we group the top group and the block 5, specify the stretch mode for the new group and the proportional stretch mode for all child objects, then the result will be correct. Separately, need to say about the size of the text. The size of the text increases and decreases according to the size of the object. This allows to preserve the appearance of buttons, titles, and captions. However, the text size of the formatted text object and formatted text block objects does not change. You can use this feature, for example, to show a large block of the text, the font of which should not be changed. Finally, let's see how scaling works on a real template.